Next, we're going to talk about how to deploy a terms of use. The first step would be to create the terms of use, which consists of adding a PDF document and tagging that with a name and a language. Next is going to be enforce that terms of use via conditional access policies. Once that conditional access policy is enforced, end users in scope of that policy will now be required to accept and agree to those terms prior to getting access. Once an end user has consented or accepted that terms of use, the admin can view auditing reports to see which user accepted what terms of use when. First demo will be showing how to enable and create a terms of use. Now that I've signed into the Azure portal, I can navigate to the terms of use blade, which I can get to via conditional access. So once I navigate to conditional access, I see terms of use on the left. And now you've reached the terms of use blade. What you see now is a list of all the current terms of use that I have on my directory. And I'm going to create a new one. Creating a new one consists of adding a couple of different names. The first name is the name that the admin can use to manage the terms of use within the portal. The second name is the name that will be presented to the end user while they are signing in. Next, I will be uploading the terms file, which is a PDF document. Once that file has been uploaded, I can tag that with a language. If needed, you can add multiple files and tag with multiple languages as you need. In this scenario, I'm just going to upload one file tagged as English. Next, you can require the users to expand the terms of use. By default, on the end user experience, the terms of use is collapsed, but this will require them to expand the terms of use before they can accept. As I mentioned previously, enforcing a terms of use is done via conditional access policies. We've added a template here to make it easier for you to get a terms of use enabled quickly, but in this scenario, I will create a conditional access policy later. Great, now we can see the terms of use was successfully created. Now in order to enforce that terms of use, it's done via conditional access policies. For more information on conditional access policies, you can reference the documents below. I'm going to navigate over to conditional access and create a new policy enforcing this terms of use. With conditional access, you can enforce the terms on specific users and groups. If you have a certain grouping like full-time employees versus guests or nurses versus doctors, you can do that here. In this scenario, I will just do apply to all users. Also, with applications, you can apply the policy to specific applications like Salesforce or Box. In this demo, I will apply to all cloud apps. Next is the actual terms of use. Within the grant control list, we now see the terms of use that I had previously created called the Contoso Guest Terms of Use. Now that that's selected, I have a conditional access policy that will require my users to agree to my terms of use before getting access to any app. Now that the conditional access policy has been created, we showed how an admin can create a terms of use and enforce that via a conditional access policy. Next, we're going to transition to what an end user will see when signing into an application. In this scenario, I'm an end user trying to sign into the Azure portal. Before I can sign in, I'm interrupted with a terms of use that I must accept before getting access. Now that I can view my terms of use, I can go ahead and accept. And it's only once I accept that I can get access to my application. In this case, the Azure portal. This shows what an end user will experience when a terms of use is enforced upon them. In this demo, we're going to review an admin looking and viewing the reports and audits of their users' consents to terms of use. I've navigated back to the terms of use blade, and I can click on the new terms of use that we had created, Contoso guest terms of use, and I can see that one user has accepted. If I click on that one, I can view a report that shows which user accepted what TOU at what time. So this shows the reports and auditing capabilities that terms of use provides to administrators so that they can view the consents of their users in their organization. Next, we're going to talk about a rollout plan and how you can actually enable and roll these terms of use out in your organization.